السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Peace be upon you all. We are standing here today to remember and commemorate the people who gave their life for a great cause. We are standing here today to remember the people, the hundreds of people who were massacred, brutally massacred by the un-Islamic state or the so-called ISIS. We are standing here today to remember the innocent victims of this brutal murder committed by an organization that calls itself Islamic, and they are far away from being Islamic. You have all come today to stand in unity, to stand in defiance against all oppressors in the world, especially those that are carrying out these brutal murders in the name of your religion, the name of Islam. Of course, we know that ISIS do not differentiate between a Christian or a Muslim or anyone else. You do remember 12th of June 2014. That was the day when hundreds, reports say more than 1,700. 1,700 is an humble estimate. Some people say it's double. It's around 3,000 students were in the Spiker camp. They were trained to be the next people to defend their country. They left their families. They left their children. Some of them are believed to have newborns. Some of them were newly wed. Imagine, you just got married, but you said, no, I want to go and train myself to defend my country, to defend my religion. They left, they went there, and suddenly some of the weak-hearted army personnel left the Spiker camp. And these people, these students who were new to the army, were misinformed, so they decided to escape from the camp. And while they were in their hundreds, not thousands, were trying to escape, around 50 to 100 of these brutal ISIS members confronted them and took them hostage. Reports say, and I'm sure some of you have actually seen the video footage of what had actually happened after that. They took them later on, where their fate will be ended. The way they murdered these people, these innocent people who just wanted to work as an army personnel to defend their country. And these people who murdered them call themselves Muslim. This is the tragedy, brothers and sisters. They call themselves Muslim and they carry the identity of Islam. They shot them, some of them on their head and threw them in the river. Whilst others, they lay on the floor and shot them on their head. The way that they killed these people, some reports say they were jubilant. They were very happy. Once they come and shoot these people, they were laughing, they were joking around. in jubilation. They were very happy that they committed these murders. What I wanted to say today is many people actually still call this terrorist organization an Islamic State. And we keep on telling them, look, there's nothing, they have nothing to do with Islam, these people. And I will prove it with just a few verses of the Holy Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 190, he says, fight in the cause of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those who fight you, right? And this is what is called jihad. Some people misinterpret jihad. Of course, we know that jihad al-akbar and jihad al-asghar, and what the verse is referring to is jihad al-asghar, the small jihad. Whereas the jihad, the big jihad is jihad al-nafs, jihad within. But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fight only those people who fight you. So in confrontation, in a war situation, when you have to defend your land, you fight those people who are fighting you. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fight in the cause of Allah, those who fight you, but do not do aggression. Note these words. For Allah loves not the aggressors. Fight in the way of Allah against those who fight against you, but begin not hostilities. Now go back to the scene when hundreds of these spiker camp students were trying to escape. Did they try to fight ISIS? They were just normal, innocent citizens wanting to go back home. Whereas ISIS came and brutally murdered them. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, fight in the cause of Allah those who fight you. But those didn't. The camp personnel, spiker camp personnel, did not fight them at all. What is the language of the Quran? Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, invite to the way of your Lord with wisdom and fair preaching, and argue with them in a way that is better. Truly your Lord knows best who has gone astray from his path, and he is the best aware of those who are guided. This is the attitude of the Quran and Islam. However, I was very interested to find out some verses that actually describe ISIS. And believe it or not, I found many verses that actually describe who ISIS are at the moment. And these particular verses that I will recite to you should be spread to the media, to the world, that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has already described to us the people of ISIS. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says in Surah Al-Baqarah, and there are some people who say, we believe in Allah and the last day, and they are not at all believers. They say, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan Rasulullah, and also believe in the hereafter. But Allah says, and they are not all believers. They desire to deceive Allah and those who believe, and they deceive only themselves, and they do not perceive. There is a disease, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes it and says, there is a disease in their hearts. So Allah added to their disease, and they shall have a painful penalty because they lied. And when it is said to them, this is all the words of the Quran, he says, and when it is said to them, do not make mischief in the land. People keep on telling them, do not make mischief in the land. They say, we are but peacemakers. This is the final verse. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, now surely they themselves are the mischief makers, but they do not perceive. They do not know. إِنَّهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes these people, and it is written in the Quran. And of course, when we come and argue and discuss with these people to tell them, look, what you are doing is wrong, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala again describes in the Quran, and He says what? He says, سُمْعٌ بُكْمٌ عُمْيٌ فَهُمْ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ. They have their eyes shut, they have their ears shut, and they have their hearts shut, and they will not listen to you. So now the world has realized the brutality of ISIS. I congratulate our British government in joining the forces, the coalition forces. And I asked the question, I asked David Cameron, who are these coalition forces that you have just joined? The coalition involves countries that have actually supported ISIS, countries that have funded ISIS. And you probably all know who these countries are. I'm going to name them. Saudi Arabia, number one. Qatar, number two. UAE, number three. And some other Arab nations. And Jordan, of course. Whereas when David Cameron comes and speaks about democratically elected country, right? He is making a coalition with countries that have leaders that are not democratically elected. Leaders that cause oppression to their people. And of course, I forgot Bahrain. And how can I forget Bahrain? And Turkey, of course. Although Turkey is not part of the coalition. But these brutal dictators have always given funds to Al-Qaeda, have given funds to extremism. And David Cameron and others would like to join the coalition to defeat ISIS. It all goes down in circle. They go and kill ISIS, and then they go and try to fund another extremist organization. And they have one main aim, is to cause havoc. And also, and I'm going to say it, one of their main aims in this world, those brutal extremists, is to kill one particular sect in Islam. Brutally kill this particular sect in Islam, and that's the Shia of Ahlul Bayt. Yes, ISIS have killed Sunnis. Yes, ISIS have killed the Kurds. Yes, ISIS have killed Christians. But if you compare the numbers of people that have killed since ISIS have emerged, then the Shia are by far the majority. When will this stop, brothers and sisters? When will this stop, the massacre of innocent people? Now, if you have a tree in your garden, and it's a really bad tree, and you really want to get rid of this tree, what would you do? Would you take off the leaves? Or would you actually go to the roots and make sure you cut the roots so that this tree will not grow again? What we need to do, brothers and sisters, and what the world needs to do, is do the following. It needs to tackle one particular school of thought that is giving rise to extremism in the world. And that is the Wahhabi school of thought. The extremism we've been saying for years and years, the Wahhabi school of thought, that school of thought that follows bin Taymiyyah, are the ones that have brought Al-Qaeda into place, are the ones that have brought ISIS into place. And of course, the Wahhabi school of thought doesn't just target the Shias, but targets the Sunnis, of course, and targets the other religions. We must stand united and advise and inform the British government and the world that to try to tackle extremism in the world, you must try to stop the spread and the teachings of Wahhabism. It's all good trying to bomb Iraq. It's all good trying to kill ISIS members. But then again, for our kids, for the next generation, they face another ISIS. And they face another ISIS, and their children will face another ISIS. Until we actually clamp down the school of Wahhabism. And of course, where does the school of Wahhabism come from? It comes mainly from Saudi Arabia. And again, we go back to the people, the Saudis who actually, and it is confirmed that they have actually supported terrorism all over the world. And mostly in Iraq. Whereas the West continuously are friends with Saudi Arabia and the other Arab countries. When will this stop? So we demand here, in this peaceful vigil, the British government to stop its relations with Saudi Arabia. If you always promote, if you think you promote human rights and democracy, then you're being hypocritical here. Saudi Arabia has the worst human rights record in the world. Stop your relations with Saudi Arabia. Stop providing arms to Saudi Arabia. Stop selling arms to Saudi Arabia. Because they are the roots of extremism. We have to clamp down on this root. We have to take the roots out, because people like ISIS will continue. I leave you today, and let's take 1 minute reflection and contemplation, and remember the people who were martyred, who were massacred in Iraq, and specifically in Spica. And don't forget that it's not just the people of Spica who have given their lives. Continuously, for the last many, many years, in fact, for the last 40 years, Iraq has seen destruction after destruction after destruction. The start of Saddam Hussein's time, which, by the way, Britain and the United States and everyone else supported the war against Iran, supported Saddam Hussein's war against Iran in the 1980s. Saddam Hussein massacred the people of Iraq, massacred our great scholars in Iraq. And then again, we had the invasion. You got rid of Saddam Hussein. You cleaned up the mess, or sort of cleaned up the mess you created, on West. And then we had Saudi Arabia and others come into Iraq and cause destruction. Let us remember all these people who have given their lives. I'm sure some of you have relatives who have died in the last 10 years, who have been martyred just because they believe in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they believe in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi wa sallam. Let us take 1 minute of silence, brothers and sisters, to remember all these people who have given their life to stop oppression and injustice in this world. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم والحمد لله رب العالمين.